as Katie Patterson gets us underway, and Tamika Butt gets the play moving. Comes out to Torpy, who starts it right back today, and go back to their very experienced captain to settle things down. Beside me in commentary today, Sarah Walsh. It's always nail-biting this time of the season, Walshy.
It is. It's the point of the year where we all get excited about what could happen next, and this last week of matches have just really just thrown everything up in the air with the recent scorelines. But here today, I think, Brisbane Roar, they have a really good team. I think they have a few more players on their roster that have been in this position before. And today's just about going through their process and working on the things that are doing well and kind of, I guess, work on the things at training that they need to develop. But, when I look at these two teams, I think we're up for a really good match today either way.
Caitlin Torfey releases Emily Gilnick on the right flank. Tries to pick out a striker centrally. Chapman brings it down in the middle of the park. And as Gorrie applies pressure, it's sent safely away by Megan Oyster. It's going to make a huge difference to the Jets today to have Gilliland back in their side.
Oh, absolutely. And, she was firing on all cylinders, playing really, really well in the first half of the season. So, unfortunately for Newcastle Jets, she was out with a quad injury, I believe, and she's going to be a great addition. I think today also is about, playing the way that you want to play in the finals, and you don't want to be the team that actually scrapes into the top four anyway. So I think, you really want to work on those things that have been working well for you. And I think when you look at Brisbane Roar today, what they do really well is actually stretch the field and use that pace and good in transition. I found the pod talk really, really interesting around the fact that Mel Andretta said that they're still trying to figure out, the balance between the two and working out when.
Indeed, well, we're going to look at their finals credentials today. 3 points, really, everything for Brisbane Roar today. Newcastle really, as you said, clinging on. They'll scrape through by the skin of their teeth should they go through. Brisbane Roar only have one match left. There is nothing to lose today.
Yeah, and absolutely. I think no matter what you do in the first half of the season, obviously it sets you up to...
Here we see Beard coming in from the left. She's been deployed further up the park. And Sarah Walsh, continue. I did say there was nothing to lose. There's actually everything to lose.
Absolutely. I think, obviously, the first half of the season performances set you up to be in a better position on the ladder. But equally, momentum and how you're playing in form, I think, plays a way bigger role. The top teams, we got to see that with Perth. The score sheet in the previous game, it just goes to show, you don't want to be going into the top four losing matches like that. Obviously, you've got to internally look at yourself, and you much prefer that match to happen in the first half of the season. So I think that matters more, and if Newcastle can turn that around today.
Well, look at the neat footwork of Tamika Butt. Managed to turn around and almost get around her defender. Of course, Angela Beard playing further up the park as well. Such a fantastically versatile player, been at left back for a large part of the season. Mel Andretta said they tried her further up the pitch during pre-season and liked what they saw. As Brisbane deliver the first corner of the game. Well, goes up to the middle. It's safely gathered in by Caitlin Rowland, Newcastle Jets keeper, who was brought in after injury, sent Kelsey Weiss home. And look at this run from Erin Gilliland. Actually stopped short. But, she's a physical player, well able to hold the ball up and really control play for the Jets.
Yeah, we got to see then she had a huge amount of support. There were blue numbers, blue shirts pushing forward to join that attack, I think. It's good signs early from them.
On her link up with Jen Hoy has been crucial throughout part of the season that they have been able to play together. Teammates, of course, in the States at Chicago Red Stars. A bit of tweaking for this Brisbane Roar back line as well. Frowsing Peterson we saw in the middle of the pitch. Ooh, dangerous ball there. Jen Hoy running in on attack. Kingsley's backing her up on the other side. Kenzie Arnold too experienced for that. Jets taking every opportunity to attack. Jen Hoy's there. Kingsley too far forward. cleared away by Torpy towards Gilnick. And Roar off on the attack once more.
I think something to watch today with the games that we've seen against Brisbane Roar, where teams go wrong is being allowed to be beaten by one pass. And if you press against Brisbane, you want to press in numbers and you want to do it controlled and with discipline. The teams that actually press quick on Brisbane, if they find a quick outlet, the one pass can beat your entire midfield and then they're off. And we all know how they can transition with the likes of Gilnick and Tamika Butt. So I think for Newcastle Jets today, they really need to be careful and pick their times when they go. Otherwise, just hold their shape and actually, you know, work it that way. But I think we've seen plenty of teams come undone against Brisbane this year.
Megan Oyster goes the aerial option a little bit beyond both Hoy and her striking counterparts. Arnold, of course, been a safe pair of hands for Brisbane this season, relatively so. Another one with Matilda's experience. And miscue from Gilnick finds the ball back with Hoy. Oyster switches the play. Lovely work from Megan Oyster, doing what she does best. Gemma Simon asked a little bit too much on that occasion. Another guest here for Newcastle Jets is Caprice Didasco today, who's paying a visit. She was such a huge part of proceedings in the last season and one of the injury disappointments that Craig Dean spoke to me about before the game. Due to return, unfortunately, an injury in one of the playoff matches in the States.
Yeah, she was another huge loss, and there's been plenty spoken about, the young players coming in to replace these really good players, and I think they've done a really good job to be where they are on the table at the moment with those losses. But they're in for a really good chance, so they actually just need to keep the ball. It's quite simple. If you lose the ball in really bad positions against a team like Brisbane Roar, with Matildas and really good players that can finish like Katrina Gorrie, if you just allow these simple things to creep into your game, that's when they hurt you.
Gorrie's ball over the top of her teammate Tamika Butt, but how about Claire Polkinghorn? Sarah Walsh, 100 appearances last week, so 101st today, almost as many for the national side. What a servant to the game.
Oh, it's unbelievable. I cannot believe she's reached 100 games, and she looks exactly the same as she did at 16, exactly the same. And you can imagine that her game's not changed too much otherwise.
No, you're absolutely right. Such a talent now in a foot race between Polkinghorn and Jennifer Hoy. Hoy gets there first, a chance to cut back. Well, it's neatly blocked off by Frowsing Peterson. Good vision from Jen Hoy, and Claire Polkinghorn looks exactly the same. Maybe not quite as pacey as she was as a 16-year-old.
Yeah, well, she's pretty quick for her age, but obviously great run there from Jen Hoy. You can see how much damage she can do when there's space.
Great defence from Frowsing Peterson. Of course, Claire Polkinghorn's only 27, so she's not a great age by any means.
I totally thought she was older than that. That is unbelievable. She's been around since she was 15.
She needs to defend here as it comes in, and that is in the back of the net already for the Newcastle Jets. Jennifer Hoy has another goal on the board, and the Jets off to the perfect start here in the Hunter. Well, just as we're talking about the Brisbane defence, questions asked already, perfectly taken corner executed by Jen Hoy, and it's a goal.
Well, you can see here the defence is actually switched off. No one has tracked Jennifer Hoy's run. It's an absolutely perfectly timed header. Great ball in, well executed corner. You can see here no one has tracked a run. Completely marking zonal, static. Everything about that was actually asking for a goal to be scored. Very, very static from Brisbane Roar.
Well, how are they going to respond now? And Katrina Gorrie's racing forward. She won't have enjoyed that start to proceedings. Just in the 10th minute here in Newcastle. And the Jets off to the ideal beginning. Well, the Jets, of course, have two games remaining after this. We might talk about the permutations in just a minute. Short corner for Brisbane. Chapman to Gorrie. This pass is cut down and it's Newcastle Jets on the counter again. Caitlin Torpy up to the task that time against Liana Danaskis. Torpy just 16 years old, but if you look at that ladder, there's a possible 9 points remaining for the Jets. So they could sneak in. They'll be dependent on other results, of course. But the only way they can give themselves a chance is with 3 wins in 3 games.
This is kind of the stuff that Craig Deans was talking about around having a young team and decision-making, and I think that very, very early in the game, and I know they're 1-0 up, but absolutely needing to really focus on their defensive discipline, Brisbane Roar will not lay down in this match, and you know they're in a really good position now to actually keep possession and try to take control of this match.
Well, that's the player on the ball at the moment that probably poses the most danger through the centre of the park. Everyone knows about the skills of Katrina Gorrie. In fact, she's been perhaps a little bit quiet throughout much of this season. But, her impact on the play, controlling the pace of the play and the energy of the Brisbane side is so crucial.
Yeah, it is. And I think a lot of teams have actually really focused on Katrina Gorrie this year. And I don't know how much, but the times when she really, really does damage, I mean, without taking anything away from her, you'll find when she's on the edge of the box smashing the ball in the top right of the net, she probably had time on the ball. And I think closing her down early and making sure that she's always pressured on the ball and having to make those decisions a lot quicker obviously limits her ability to be able to have that control over the match. And I think teams have really done a lot better in that this year. But equally, she finds the space if she needs to. She, you know, if she's on her game today, it won't matter how tight she's marked.
Well, in closing down one player at Brisbane Roar is always fraught with danger, as we can see. Tamika Butt almost gets it to the feet of Angela Beard. Do you like Beard playing further up?
Well, I'm yet to see her there. This is actually the first time I've seen her. I actually really love her at left back. I really do. I think maybe they thought they needed something extra.
Oh, Gilnick goes for Torpy on the near side. Returns the favour. Maddie Evans waiting centrally. Popping Horner. It's a bit of a tumble. Retrieves possession. Eventually it's over the whitewash for a Newcastle throw. But there's so many dangerous attacking weapons in the Brisbane side. So many Matildas. The international experience is... We're just trying to work it out before, second to none in the WLeague.
Yeah, I think it's more about, they do have a lot of players, obviously, that they're required to step up, like Summer O'Brien. I think Joey Peters alluded to this earlier on, that it's about the other players around them. And, you know, we have Frowsing Peterson who will play a huge role, Evans in the midfield. We don't talk a lot about these players, but they play huge roles for this team. But what we're finding with Newcastle Jets right now, and we're only early in the match, but they're closing down the space really early, and they're not giving Brisbane Roar time on the ball, and they're making the field smaller, which obviously hurts Brisbane Roar's ability to be able to go forward in transition.
Well, the searching ball from Megan Oyster has gone to Jenna Kingsley, who fires a shot off. Relieved Mackenzie Arnold grasps it in. That's another dangerous moment for the Roar. Not sure Megan Oyster meant the ball to end up quite there, but managed to scuttle through all the players in the middle of the park. And Simon back to Kingsley. He's doing battle royal with Caitlin Torpy. Gilnick looking for options. It's Cassidy Davis that chases back in the Newcastle defence.
Yeah, Cassidy Davis, she's done a really, really good job in this team and holding the fort in the back line. What they need to work on today is actually being in a right position to be able to counter that quick early ball in behind. They've handled it very well so far.
Neat control from Tamika Butt back to Torpy. Amy Chapman wound up, ball went nowhere, a trip for Hoy. Falkenhorn disagrees.
A little bit lucky here to not get a pick up a yellow. Jen Hoy had actually, I don't know if she had possession of the ball, but she obviously was off to chase it.
Davis delivery down to Torpy, another one of those youngsters that you spoke about. Got the most experienced W League player and the youngest Brisbane Roar player together in the back line. Chapman away again. Gorry. Well beyond Tamika Butt. That combination has worked so many times for Brisbane Roar.
They have such a great understanding of each other's game. I think what will be key for Brisbane Roar is getting the ball early to Emily Gilnick. Out wide, being able to show her support.
Busy Katrina Gorry, really showing her worth, and that's a poke through by Gemma Simon. It's cleaned up by Summer O'Brien in the Brisbane Roar back line. Decent amount of pressure on the Roar defence. Get the sense that the Jets realise that this is all or nothing. We again. Libby Copus-Brown on the far side, back in the side after an injury. She returned along with Gilliland today.
I'd be interested to know about the weather down there, Steph. This has been a pretty slow-paced match so far. The pace of the ball, the pace of the movement off the ball.
Well, Brisbane Roar haven't dealt with it. Kingsley was there. Gilliland sniffing around as well. Blocked off again by Newcastle Jets. Now Wheeler doing battle with Beard. Oh, comes in over the top of Arnold, and it's a second for Newcastle. Brisbane can't believe it, but the Jets are celebrating. Only temporarily, though. It's been cut off by the offside flag going up on the far side.
Well, again, sorry, Steph. Unbelievable ball in. Jenna Kingsley, back post run. Well executed. But no one marking the player at the back of the box. It's a huge worry for Brisbane Roar. Completely ill-disciplined.
Yeah, it's something Mel Andriotta won't like watching right now. Because if this is crucial for the Newcastle Jets, then Brisbane Roar, no, it's absolutely a must-win for them. We'll have another look at that goal. Disallowed for offside.
Look at the two Newcastle Jets players at the back post. We've got Emily Gilnick ball watching, hasn't even tracked that runner. Equally, Torpy didn't even know where a player was. And here, free header, absolutely perfectly timed header from Kingsley.
Yeah, I can see why she was celebrating. It looked fantastic. However, wasn't to be. Score still 1-0 to the Jets. And stays that way as Roland clutches at Amy Chapman's delivery. Well, the Jets certainly looking very lively. And you asked about the conditions, Sarah. It's really so steamy down there. The temperature is quite comfortable, but it feels so hot, and you can't imagine that a high-pressing game is going to be something that eventuates for 90 minutes.
Well, we're seeing that now. Look where Brisbane Roar are starting their press, which is actually quite deep and not what we're used to seeing from them.
Once again, ball not completely closed down by Summer O'Brien on the far side. Brisbane Roar perhaps second to the ball a few times too many as Gorry seeks out Tamika Butt once more. Not come to fruition yet. There's a long way to go here. Composed ball from Torpy back to Arnold. Brisbane after going a goal down and having a second scare so soon after. Just perhaps need to settle their nerves. More pressure from Jen Hoy. In fact, it's the Jets applying all the pressure down that end of the park. Let's have another look at that offside decision.
Yeah, pretty good call there. Just an inch in it with Jenna Kingsley offside. Excellent header with a very narrow angle.
Kingsley leading the goal-scoring stats for Newcastle. Well, in fact, she's level now with Jennifer Hoy after Hoy's goal in the 10th minute. Both of them with five apiece for this season. Of course, that golden boot standing led by Samantha Kerr with 10 for Perth Glory. And after four goals yesterday, Ash Sykes has joined her up there on 10 goals for the season.
It's unbelievable numbers.
Extraordinary if you miss the games that were played on Saturday. Two enormous scores, 21 goals scored across both grounds. Now Simon tries to prod the ball past Torpy. Angle too difficult.
I think what we've found, I can't speak to the last two matches, but in particular that Canberra match against Sydney FC and Canberra come out and have a game like they did last match. You take one really, really good player out of the back line and I'm finding that it basically just falls to pieces for some of these teams. It's a little bit of a worry, and I think it's a huge factor in what's happening.
Yes, indeed. Well, Jets run cut off this time, pushing the back for Summer O'Brien. No whistle as yet. Play on, Jets with the throw. Tried to thread through for Kingsley, didn't come off that time. Newcastle back in possession, too many cheap turnovers from Brisbane Roar in dangerous areas. Now Simon for the Jets, over the top, searching for Jennifer Hoy. She's found her. Still with Hoy. It's around Torpy, headed away by Frowsing Peterson. And eventually safely at the feet of Katrina Gorrie.
Except the last 5 minutes, Newcastle Jets have had 65% of the possession.
Well, now Wheeler goes once more to Hoy. Jets on the attack again. Yes, indeed. Possession fairly one-sided in the recent few minutes.
It's a real worry if Brisbane Roar can't keep the ball to be able to gain possession and move up the park in meaningful possession. This is actually going to build confidence for Newcastle Jets, and you can see they're having no problem in holding the ball at the moment, making it really difficult with that high press against Brisbane. And Brisbane, the real worry is that there's not a huge amount of movement off the ball. Players are looking out with the ball and not finding easy options, and that's basically the opposite to what Newcastle Jets are doing, the work off the ball.
Newcastle Jets haven't had that winning feeling in 7 weeks. And difficult to believe when you watch them play in a structure like this. They seem to be composed. Of course, those scores don't really tell the tale because they were close matches, 3 draws in the last few weeks. And Brisbane with a little bit of space to balance the ledger, and now it's Gilnick. Only with lots of room. It goes back for Chapman. It's blocked off by Megan Oyster. A careful eye on the boot of Amy Chapman. It's turned over once more. Gorrie, Chapman. Maddie Evans has the ball taken off her. Now with Claire Wheeler and Newcastle Jets. Back on the offensive. And just as quickly, Maddie Evans for Brisbane Roar. Holds it through the middle. Megan Oyster there again. She's been an impenetrable brick in the wall of the Jets' defence. Neither side really doing enough to really look after possession.
You see Brisbane here. They're stringing 10 passes together and not really going anywhere, and then basically just turning it over really easy. And again, I have to say it, there's no other options off the ball. And then hitting hopeful passes, the 1% of passes that are possibly going to be turned over, and they're kind of happy with that to then set up their shape. But It is all to do with their movement and their shape. A little bit disjointed. And the time where they did get forward there through Emily Gilnick, it was that quick pass to take out five Newcastle Jets players. They're so much more comfier playing transition football.
Well, Mel Andriotta spoke pre-game about what she thought as Newcastle Jets retrieve the ball once more. Jennifer Hoy again involved in the thick of the action. Damascus back to Oyster for safety. Oyster's had success there before. Gilliland was there, leaped high, clashed heads with Caitlin Torpy, who's down on the turf, but Brisbane are away further up the park. Emily Gilnick, and careless pass perhaps beyond Tamika Butt.
What's the wrong decision there? They had plenty of numbers. You can see the heartache on Tamika Butt's face. She's made a really good run out wide. She's just disappointed that it wasn't played to her feet. Again, it's the wrong decision. And this must frustrate Mel Andretta because they have amazing players on the park. That ball goes straight out to Tamika Butt. Emily Gilnick can get it back, but here we can see that Torpy's been hit.
Fortunately, Caitlin Torpy up and running around again. It's interesting about Newcastle Jets as pressure again placed on by Hoy and Kingsley. Jets have it back again. Erin Gilliland, still with Gilliland, gets her left boot wrapped around it, not quite the angle she was after. But they've been awarded a corner.
Gillian has just been excellent today. She's playing a little bit higher up on the defensive line. I think it's actually confusing Brisbane Roar a little bit. We've got the pace of Kingsley to worry about. They've got Jen Hoy, but this player on screen here, Gilliland, they have absolutely missed her. You can see they're a different team when she's on the park, Steph. Absolutely brilliant at finding the space, finding the ball. She demands that service from her players, and she's just such a delight to watch.
Newcastle Jets with another corner headed away by Maddie Evans here from the Orlando Pride. Danaskos sends in a ball that takes a heavy deflection and it's back with Katrina Gorry, not for long. Evans again. Jen Hoy and Gilliland, the linchpins of this side. Now Kingsley. Gemma Simon. Closely guarded by Claire Polkinghorne. With good result. Excellent work defensively from Polkinghorne.
Yeah, absolutely. She knew Gemma Simon was left foot and was always going to spin around again to get that cross in. Well defended.
Gilliland again applying the pressure. Spent last season with Chicago Red Stars. Originally born in Kentucky and came to them from Kansas City and Brisbane. Another poor decision. Sees the ball turned over once more.
It just seems they're playing with a little bit of panic. There's no composure about their game at the moment. And that forces them to play the balls that are not on.
Well, that was almost on. For Newcastle Jets, and look at the tenacity of Jennifer Hoy, tracking back to pressure the keeper, running down balls. Look like they're out. Certainly been a super addition to Craig Dean's side this season. Brisbane Roar, a chance to assess, a bit of space. Gorry weaves away around Danaskis. Now with Madeline Evans. Evans for Brisbane. Fancies a shot. Straight into the waiting hands of Caitlin Rowland. Again, just lacking those options up top.
There was a lot better play from Brisbane Roar. There was a lot of movement. There was a lot of overlapping runs, confusing the defence.
Seems that the Newcastle Jets are finding all the options at the other end of the park as Megan Oyster manages to avoid the danger of Tamika Butt. O'Brien comes steaming through. Brisbane attack again as the bright sunshine comes out over McDonald Jones Stadium. Evans back to Butt. Not a lot of room for the Brisbane attack to move. Now it's Beard. Tumbles over the feet of McIntyre. McIntyre wins that particular battle. Kingsley deemed to have fouled Katrina Gorrie. The half hour mark has ticked over here in Newcastle. It's still 1-0 to the Jets. As we see Grace McIntyre doing battle. Gorrie's ball to Gilnick. Oh, and a blatant handball. It's a netball move.
Yeah, well, when things aren't going your way, silly things happen like that. You can see their quick go-to is always Emily Gilnick, and I think it's becoming a little bit predictable.
Is that not a yellow card when it's
possibly.
That clear?
Possibly. It's one of those brain snaps she's had, but you can see that. I'm not even sure if that was the right option from Katrina Gorrie to hit that out to Emily Gilnick. Good position to be able to swing a ball in and make the keeper have to do something, make a save, get her involved.
Not all falling into place for Brisbane Roar at the moment. It's a big occasion, desperate for a win with only one match remaining in their WLeague regular season. They sit 1 point behind fourth spot. And as the ladder stands right now. It's out beyond Summer O'Brien. It just isn't clicking for them. Of course, the match for Brisbane next week, the final match of their regular season, is against Melbourne City, the side ahead of them on the table. Melbourne City still to play later on this evening. It's the Melbourne Derby. Brisbane not a team that we normally worry about with high pressure. We saw their performance in the semi-finals last season, came out of nowhere throughout the regular season, and were the only side that at that point managed to hold Melbourne City to a draw.
I'm actually starting to notice a bit of frustration coming out through the players, especially the high-level players. I did witness something between Katrina Gorrie, Gilnick and Tamika Butt that found a two-on-one situation. It wasn't played.
Well, Danaskos with a lovely ball through to Jenna Kingsley. Kingsley with Summer O'Brien between her and the goal. Still Kingsley. Slides it neatly through. Angela Beard dropping back into defence. Crowsing Peterson managed to clear it all away. Kingsley was waiting, and now it's O'Brien. Ball reaches Megan Oyster, who happily turns and continues the attack. This time it's Jennifer Hoy. Still Hoy gets around O'Brien. Still with Hoy. And more danger, smile on her face. The American jumps to her feet.
That was an excellent run from Jennifer Hoy, beating Summer O'Brien with his first touch here, obviously getting a body in and really pushing to get in front. You can see taking that extra touch too much. But again, she's such a dangerous player when she's on the ball. You can see she's having a ball out there.
She certainly is. It's the Brisbane Roar, perhaps. Not so much enjoying proceedings thus far. Plenty of Matildas on the park, and the national team coach is down here. He's sideline with Amy Duggan.
Thank you, Steph. Alan, great to have your company here again today. I know you get around
to it. Wait, as Emily Gilnick punches the ball through towards the goal.
almost.
And fingertip. Back to you, Amy.
Sorry. Close call there. Stage will keep our eye on the game at the same time. It's great to see you here again today. I just want to ask you what you make of the scorelines yesterday and the week before as my first question.
Yeah, look, extraordinary. I was at the Canberra-Perth game and it was 7-0 after 50 minutes, and really it could have been anything. Could have been 11-5 by the end of the game. So it was extraordinary play. Extraordinary attacking play. Bit of a concern defensively from both teams, but some of the play going forward from Sam Kerr on one team and DiBernardo and Nash Sykes and crew on the other side was really amazing. It was good to watch.
There's five Matildas in this Brisbane team. How are they travelling, and are they still aspiring for that top four spot in your eyes?
Yeah, look, former Matildas, we have to pick the team again, so that cycle's over. So, yeah, look, there's an incumbency there, but obviously we've got to pick a new team going into the next four-year cycle. So all the spots are up for grabs and every player's playing for a spot every week, that's for sure.
Well, that was my next question. Do you have any time frame on that at the moment? And will we see some fresh faces?
Yeah, look, we definitely will, and we really got to plan for the next 4 years. So we've got a World Cup and Olympics 3-4 years away, and the Asian Cup's, you know, a year and a half away. So we really got to look forward and plan for the future rather than just for the Algarve, which we'll pick our squad around mid-February for our first camp on February the 15th.
All right, great. Thank you for your time today. I'll let you enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much, Amy Duggan, with Alan Stajic, the national team coach. And, of course, as is always the case, as soon as he started speaking, almost an absolute screamer from Emily Gilnick.
Well, I love that he's thrown down that statement.
Well, Gorry charging forward now. One of the incumbents, if you like. Tripped over, no whistle. Now Gilnick keeps the ball in. Crosses over, looking for the head of Angela Beard.
He's thrown down the statement of all positions are vacant. This is exciting. Really exciting. And it makes the WLeague more exciting. Here's the replay here. Katrina Gorry being closed down. She'd been running with the ball. Made a fair amount of distance and taken out. That was a stunning strike from Emily Gilnick when we were talking to Alan Stajic. Absolutely stunning. I think she's definitely done enough to be able to get his interest for at least for Algarve. I really just like, I've spoken about it before, she's adding to her game constantly, and good players are always looking to develop, and she's done that. I think she has a really good understanding of her development areas. She's working on them.
Certainly has. Tall, strong forward. Started out as a super sub in her early days at the Raw. Become an integral part of proceedings now. Maddie Evans. Gorry. Brisbane try to find some way to restore parity, and I suppose on the back of Gilnick's wonderful attempt, Caitlin Rowland, what a fabulous fingertip save.
That was excellent. It dipped perfectly for Emily Gilnick, and she struck it as, I guess, as good as you could strike it. And as you said, Rowland getting the fingertips on it. I think the key for Brisbane Roar today will be keeping this level of frustration down and being able to, I guess, rely on their bigger players to step up in these tough moments. And it's only 1-0 now. It's not too high to climb, but if they continue to play this way, Newcastle Jets are only going to grow in confidence. They're moving the ball superbly.
Well, and it's landed very nicely indeed for Erin Gilliland. Still on for Newcastle. The Brisbane defence closes in. Chapman that time successful. Tangle of legs between Gemma Simon and Katrina Gorry. Decision goes with Brisbane. Some of the Brisbane players down to walking pace. Ball comes off. Katie Patterson gets involved in the play.
I'm not sure if that ball's on today with Megan Oyster. She's probably one of the best centre-backs that we have playing in the league, and continually Brisbane Roar are hitting this long ball. It's hopeful, and they're hoping that she makes a mistake, and she's not the kind of player that's going to make one. I'll probably just put the mocker on her, but... These hopeful balls to Tamika Butt, I understand that, you know, on the occasion they're going to be effective, but high percentage, they're probably going to be cut out, and then you're going to have to get your shape again and win the ball back.
A bit of casual play from Brisbane Roar sees Newcastle Jets on yet another attack. Megan Oyster, very reliable, 22nd appearance today for the Jets over here from the Washington Spirit, and she tells me she loves coming here because all the grounds back home. She's originally from Chicago. She said they're all under a foot of snow, so it's much nicer to be playing out here in the heat.
Well, we've seen a bit of a pattern from the US players, the really good ones that come out here and trying to get that extra football under their belt. But Megan Oyster is one of those ones that's come out here, and I feel like she's going to apply a trade and stamp her authority in the US national team.
Well, that's what she's certainly hoping for, and hoping perhaps that's what this next season will bring. Teammate Erin Gilliland, or her compatriot, should I say, Erin Gilliland, had her first foray into national team camp at the end of last year, and it's something Megan hopes comes her way. And performances like this can only back that up.
Well, and the direction that Jill Ellis is, the US national team coach, is taking that team, spots are up for grabs. I'm loving it. This is always the pattern in between the start of a cycle, as Alan Stajic just said. Everything is up for grabs because it's another 4 years. Your older players are going to be 4 years older. How are they going to be? So you really need to start looking at the next generation. And here it is, Gilliland and Oyster for the US national team. They're two very capable players. I don't think we really grasp how lucky we are to have them in our league and starting to see something develop within their career.
Well, and when you add their fellow countrywoman, Jen Hoy, to the equation here for the Jets, it's making a wonderful combination at WLeague level, certainly. Less than 5 minutes of regular time remaining in this first half. It is still the Newcastle Jets leading by 1-0, courtesy of Jennifer Hoy, and that pass just not coming off for Katrina Gorrie again.
But she's a joy to watch when she gets on the ball. The touches that she has, the skill set that she can draw on in the middle of the park. She just took out three players with one turn. I tell you, I would have dreamed of doing that as a player.
So what's missing on the end of the pass?
Well, I think she just made the wrong decision. Still looks good.
Katrina Gorrie always looks good. Now Maddie Evans, another one of the Americans choosing to ply her trade. She plays over at Orlando Pride with one Tom Samani. See, the heat must be starting to have some effect. It's all very lethargic out there.
It's been like that for the entire half, and I must say that it's probably suited Newcastle Jets. Brisbane have looked really lethargic on the ball, off the ball mostly.
Now Chapman twisting and turning back to Claire Polkinghorne. It's a neat ball from Polkinghorne to Gilnick. Dukes it straight into the body of Gemma Simon. Wonderful battle there, two experienced players, Gemma Simon in the high 90s of W League appearances as well. Back to captain the Jets this season. Could that drop for Tamika Butt? And Katie Patterson points to the spot. Will we see parity before the break?
Well, we've been watching Tamika Butt up against Oyster all match, and this time it was Cassidy Davis. And Cassidy Davis, she couldn't help it. She couldn't help it. Tamika Butt was off, and that's a clear penalty any time of the day, any day of the week. Tamika Butt, really, really smart move there, making sure she pushed the ball forward. It's a clear penalty. And now she's getting a yellow for dissent.
Cassidy Davis unhappy with the decision. The first one into Katie Patterson's notebook. Won't help proceedings for the Jets, and Tamika Butt stands ready to take the penalty. Patterson arranging the players, making sure everyone's back behind the line. Well, Butt get one back for Brisbane. The ball does roll under the hand of Caitlin Rowland. And the Roar are back on level terms here in the Hunter. Thought Caitlin Rowland might have had that for a moment.
Well, the penalty actually reflects the first half of Brisbane Roar. You can see here just scraping in. And you have a feeling that this is all Brisbane Roar needed to be able to get back into this match. A little bit of luck or a little bit of unfortunate play here for Newcastle Jets, all the hard work that they've done, but Brisbane Roar, you just got to think this is probably a moment that will settle them to be able to play the football we're accustomed to watching.
We'll see if it helps. It was wonderful timing for the Roar as Jen Hoy surges forward. There will be the one additional minute of time added on to this first half, but what a time for Brisbane to equalise. That will have a much happier dressing room, one suspects, at half time. Tamika Butt, four goals now in two games. Had three last week, one chalked up as an own goal to the keeper. A hat-trick to Tamika Butt. In fact, she's had a hat-trick of hat-tricks before. She's had pretty much every award known to women's football.
Yeah, she's been around for such a long time and a great servant to the game. See how dangerous she is when you get in around the box. You're really just going to be careful in the way that you approach her. She's always looking to go forward, so keep that in mind when you're defending against her.
Yeah, very energetic player. Tamika Butt been plying her trade over in Europe. And she'll get a break now as the whistle of Katie Patterson signals the break here at McDonald Jones Stadium in the Hunter. Well, it's been somewhat slow at times first half. Jen Hoy had the home crowd celebrating first with a goal in just under 10 minutes. Tamika Butt equalising with a penalty. So at halftime, the score here in the Hunter, Newcastle Jets 1. Gets us underway for this second 40.